And as Antonsen, European Games is on also for you now. How did you see your performance against Dukin yesterday?
I think it was a fine performance. Yeah, and I'm happy to get started here. It's we've been practicing hard the last few weeks, so I'm excited to get in back in competition again.
How big a goal is the European Games for you?
I mean, it's a big goal. It's kind of like our European Championships, so of course it's a big thing in itself. And yeah, and then there's this Olympic race that everyone talks about. So yeah, that has started has started as well. And there are some points here that I want to bring with me.
I'm not going to say it's going to be an easy one to win the European Games, because it isn't. But Victor Axelsen, your countryman, is not here due to sickness and illness. Where does that leave you, Victor, not participating in the Games here?
Of course, the opportunity gets a lot better when Victor's not here. He was the strongest opponent and the top seed. So yeah, that's a big difference when he's not here. So as you said, it's not going to be easy anyway. There is a lot of good guys out there who I will have a hard time playing against. So yeah, but yeah, of course, it's a big difference.
Anders, a few years ago in Scotland, as far as I recall, you said in an interview after winning Scottish Open that I am the next one for Danish badminton. How has that affected the life of yours on and off court? It's 3 years mostly now. Some people might say it was a bit arrogant, some saying it's with self-confidence. How has it been seeing you since that famous phrase almost?
It has been fun. I mean, it's been something that I have had to talk about a lot in interviews and stuff like that. So yeah, I don't feel like there has been extra pressure on me or stuff like that. I mean, I said it because I believed in it. Yeah, and I think I'm on track. I'm doing okay. So yeah, that's still the goal.
But was it a bit too much at that time to call yourself the next one? It's a big thing, especially in Denmark, when you look in the history books, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a thing that you see a lot from a Danish guy, because we have this Jantelov that you cannot believe you are something. So so I've never been a really big fan of that law. I don't know. I didn't feel that it put extra pressure on me or anything like that. So yeah, I'm always been a guy with good confidence, and yeah, I still am.
Do you still believe that you're the next one?
I actually don't know when you are the next one. But as I said, I think I'm doing okay, and I'm still heading towards it. So, but when you are the next one or the one, I don't really know. But yeah, I don't know.
But are you the first Dane to win the European Games in men's singles?
I hope so. I really hope so. That's of course the goal here in Minsk. So yeah, I hope that I can claim the title, and I feel well prepared. So it's going to be exciting.